Greetings everyone, welcome back to my channel. So new viewers, do subscribe and watch please, because YouTube says that most of my viewers haven't yet subscribed. So unfair, is it not? Do subscribe to get notifications of my videos. Well, let's get into track with the third episode of citation series. So what is the topic today? Integrating quotations into prose, which is one of the frequent challenges that any research scholar faces in his or her research area. So this book follows the rules of the 9th edition of the MLA handbook. So what do you do to construct quotation? So here, something that you have to keep in mind is that you have to reproduce the source text exactly. I mean, without any changes. Do not change spelling, capitalization, interior punctuation, italicization from the original text. So you have to place the citation at the end of the quotation for reference. Well, what will you do for short quotations? So a prose quotation that runs not more than 4 lines should be placed within the quotation marks. And this can be very easily incorporated into the prose. So for example, I have taken a sentence, right? A sentence, and I have to quote it. So what have I done? As the critic comments, and then comes the quotation marks and the original text, the quotation ends. And now you have to bring in the parenthetical citation. So Maurya, space, page number, close the parenthesis, and then comes the full stop. So here you understand that the parenthetical citation is placed between the closing quotation mark and the sentence period. Got it? Well, so do you think that we have to choose only a whole sentence or 2 or 3 sentences for quotation? No. You can even choose a word or a phrase for a quotation. So instead of picking up a sentence or two, you can even quote a word or a phrase. So this particular quoted word or phrase can be incorporated or integrated into the sentence structure. The quoted word or phrase may be added in the beginning, middle, or even at the end of the sentence and can be divided by your word. So sometimes you won't need the entire sentence or sentences. So in that case, you can be so specific and you can choose a word or a phrase. For example, here in the first example, you must have seen only a single word has been chosen for quoting purpose. The protagonist was offended. This particular word, offended, is the only word chosen by the original, chosen from the original source. So the protagonist was offended, close the inverted quotation marks, by Dr. Sam's racist remark. And here at the end, you bring in the page number for reference. And then comes the full stop. Yes. And now look into the second sentence or second example. So initially you choose up a phrase from the original text, right? Close the quotation marks and then come up with your own words. He was obeyed, and then comes your own words, writes Joseph Conrad of the company manager in Heart of Darkness, comma, and then you come up with a few more words, right? Yet he inspired neither love nor fear nor even respect. You close it, brings in the page reference, and then close the parenthesis, and then comes the full stop or the period. So now keep something in mind. It's not like you have to choose a whole sentence or a 2 or 3 more sentences. It's not like that. You can be very specific in choosing a word or even a phrase. Well, Now, what will you do for long quotations? So long quotations are otherwise called as block quotations. So here, when you have to quote more than four lines, you need not bring in quotation marks. Yes, you have to set off the entire text that contains more than four lines from the text. You have to block the text away from the margin. I mean, you have to indent half an inch from the margin. So the prose that introduces the long quotation. So when you bring in a long or a block quotation, please keep something in mind. You have to bring in a prose that introduces the long quotation. So in that case, the prose should end with a colon. I'll show you an example. So here you get an example for long or block quotation introduced with a colon. So here, this is your prose part. So you're telling that Rushdie, in his definition of the Commonwealth literature, displays his doubt in the stability of the category. So now you're introducing the block quotation. And so what you have to do is, at the end of that introduction given by your prose, you have to put in a colon, and then comes the entire text. So then here you have to see that before the parenthetical citation, there comes the full stop or the period. So for this is the difference that you find between the short quotation and the long quotation. So here in the long quotation, the period comes in before the parenthetical reference and not after the parenthetical reference, right? So now here you see that how do you integrate your block quotation into the sentence structure of your prose? In case if you integrate your block quotation into your prose construction, you don't need a colon, right? So here you have described or you have integrated the sentence structure of your prose. So here, look at the example. The same passage is repeated for both examples. So here, the introductory prose says that Rushdie is skeptical about the stability of Commonwealth literature, as it is the body of writing that is created in English. And here you put up a comma and then continue with the block quotation. You have introduced and you have integrated it within your prose. So here you don't need a colon anymore. And as usual, towards the end, you could see that the period or the full stop comes before the parenthetical reference. And after the parenthetical reference, there is no punctuation marks at all. Hope you'd have understood the difference between the short quotation and long quotation in prose, right? So practice more so that you will become experts in research. So here you could see the reference books that I've taken. And thank you for watching. Again, I repeat, those who haven't subscribed yet, do subscribe. And this is Wahida signing off.